Greetings. Thank you, Brother Jameen, for your great question. I would really like to give you a more full, clear answer than my short message. But Jesus said, if I go not away, the converter will not come. If I go away, I will send him to you, which means the converter was not there when Jesus walked the earth. So the converter you are talking cannot be the Holy Ghost. Or do you mean Jesus doesn't have the Holy Spirit with him? And I'm overlooking this misuse of the word converter instead of comforter. You asked, do you mean Jesus doesn't have the Holy Spirit with him? There is no question, brother, that Jesus had the Holy Spirit with him, in him. In John 3:34, this is Prophet John or Yahya speaking of Jesus. The one whom God sent speaks the words of God, because God does not give the Spirit in limited measure to him. Does not give in limited measure, meaning God gave the Holy Spirit to Jesus in unlimited measure, unlimited amount. So there is no question, brother, Jesus had the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was indeed already there, as Islam's argument includes. So let's get back to your question. But Jesus said, if I go not away, the Comforter will not come. If I go away, I will send him to you. Which means the Comforter was not there when Jesus walked the earth. This is a great question, brother, and a common error repeated within Islam's teachings. The logic of Islam's argument is the following, and let me know if you think I get this wrong. Jesus said he would send the Comforter. Therefore, the Comforter could not have already been there. We know that the Holy Spirit was already there. Therefore, the Holy Spirit, who was already there, could not be the entity Jesus would send. I think that summarizes the Islamic argument attempted to deny that the Holy Spirit is the Comforter, which incidentally is who Jesus actually named in John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, or Holy Pneuma in the Greek, meaning spirit. So please just be aware that in the text, Jesus already identifies who the Comforter is. If Islam disagrees, Islam disagrees with Jesus himself, not with me. Let's first look carefully at what Jesus said as he described the Comforter. John 14:16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he, the Comforter, may abide with you forever. I hope we can agree that Jesus is talking about the Comforter. Even the Spirit of Truth. In the first phrase describing the Comforter, Jesus calls him the Spirit of Truth. It is important to note Jesus did not say a truthful prophet. But that is not the critical phrase you must be aware of, brother. Even the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not. Jesus says the world cannot receive the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, because the world cannot see him. If the Comforter is a spirit, it makes sense he cannot be seen. However, if Muhammad is the Comforter, the world can see Muhammad. The world can receive Muhammad. Neither knoweth him. The world does not know and cannot know the Holy Spirit. If the Comforter is a spirit, this makes sense. However, if Muhammad is the Comforter, the world could know Muhammad. In fact, the world knew Muhammad, but you know him, for he dwelleth with you. And this is the critical phrase to think about, brother. Jesus is talking about the Comforter, And Jesus says the disciples already know him. But you know him, for he dwells with, or lives with, you. If the disciples already knew the Comforter, and if the Comforter already lives with the disciples, Jesus has just revealed the error in the Islamic argument and in your thinking. The Islamic argument is based on the error that the Comforter cannot already be here. The Comforter was already in the earth. And if you think logically, brother, if the Comforter was already in the earth, anyone who was not already in the earth could not be the Comforter. This actually proves Muhammad could not be the Comforter, brother. But the Islamic argument does raise an important point to understand, brother. Jesus clearly claims he will send the Comforter in the future. But Jesus also said the Comforter was already there. And I understand that seems confusing if you do not pay attention to the detail Jesus said. Let me try and explain it to you, brother. The key verse is John 14:17, where Jesus first describes the Comforter and speaks of two times. The first time period mentioned is the present, and Jesus speaks in something called the present tense, saying that the disciples already knew the Comforter. In the present tense, Jesus said the Comforter lived with, meaning already lived with, the disciples. And the word with is called the operative word. With describes the relationship between the Comforter and the disciples. The Comforter lived with the disciples. Then in the last phrase of John 14:17, Jesus changes tense to the future tense. He does this to mention a later time, the time after he has sent the Comforter. He does this using two small words, shall be. These words identify the time when the words that follow will apply. And the words that follow are the words in you. Jesus says, shall be in you. Jesus was essentially saying the Comforter lives with you right now, but after I send him, he will live in you. The description of the Comforter makes perfect sense, brother, when we pay attention to all the words that Jesus said, and when we are seeking knowledge and understanding. The truth is that the Holy Spirit fulfilled Jesus' promise of the Comforter almost 600 years before Muhammad was born. The reason Islam must even make this argument is to defend Surahs 7, 157 through 158, and Surah 61:6, where Muhammad claimed he was foretold in the Torah and Bible. Claiming Muhammad is the Comforter was simply some Muslim trying to twist a statement by Jesus to fit Muhammad. But it is not a logical claim, brother, nor is it respectful of what Jesus actually said. The words that Jesus said completely refute the argument that Muhammad was potentially the Comforter. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.